stop people from taking advantage of you.
Someone's been taking advantage of me.
I have, for one.
I've never even intimated.
We need to hurry. Well? Well?
Greetings, sorceress.
Greetings, Brandon.
I didn't expect you to bring company.
Is that a problem?
By the eternal fire, no. I'm surprised, that's all. Together, I expect you to resolve things twice as fast. You've the look of true experts. But I'd prefer you not to tarry and begin.
Triss, you and Brandon here. You've agreed a price.
We settled on a full coin purse.
Brandon & Co. is a serious outfit. We've the largest granary in all Novigrad.
All right then, let's get to work.
We need to place these crystals around the granary, near anything that looks rat-related. Ah! Where do you think you're going? Warehouse job won't wait, you know.
Where Ready?
Not yet.
Watch it, Trey.
It's a waste of words.
Looks like a good spot.
I don't like that guy.
Brandon? I don't either. He's much too fat.
Can't help but agree. But no, notice how he didn't try to haggle?
Must really want the rats out.
Triss, he's a merchant. He makes his living by haggling.
If I worried about that sort of thing, I'd starve to death in this city.
Hey, Spicy, how are you?
Think I plugged every hole in there.
All right. Get ready for some magic fireworks. Once I activate the incense, we'll have a moment to talk. Well? Well? Now we wait for them to scurry away.
Interesting method. Never had much luck with rats. Once I hit one with a fork in complete darkness, trying to show off my witcher's senses. Masterful throw, really. Problem was, no one else saw it. How could they in the dark?
So, what do you think? Rat catcher? It's a long way to fall from being advisor to Temeria's king.
I'm just glad to see you safe and sound, and...
reconciled?
Knew a man once who reacted to everything, especially adversity, by mocking it.
Healthy attitude. Must have lived long.
Came a day he lost both his legs in battle. He shrugged, said it was better that way. He'd never feel pain in them again.
I understand him perfectly.
I know. Thing is, he was lying to himself.
I think he just didn't have much of a choice.
We all lie sometimes, but lying to yourself is running away, whereas there's really nowhere to run.
Sometimes you have to escape, just to forget. Your friend might have dwelled on his lost legs, but it's not like by grieving he could have grown another pair. So, tell me how Yen's doing.
How do you know I found her?
You didn't answer my question. How's Yen?
She's fine.
That's good.
Asking about anything specific?
Never mind. I got my answer.
Well, well. Are lovebirds having themselves a little chat instead of working?
The job's done. Geralt, those are...
I know who they are, Triss.
My friends begged me to notify them if I encountered a mage, sorceress, what have you. Didn't have the heart to refuse.
It's a trap, Geralt.
This stank from the start.
Such a sharp sense of smell. You should have legged it while you had the chance.
I don't generally leg it. Here's what I think you should do. Pay up and march your boys out of here while there's still time.
Don't be ridiculous. I didn't hire a sorceress in order to pay her.
Take my advice, mutant. If it's not your business, stay out of it.
Thanks for the advice, but I can't take it. All right, we've talked. Do what you gotta. Just remember, I can't help but get in your way.
Heard enough from this horse, son.
As have I. Neither is to leave here alive.
Looking for a bruising?
If not for you, we need to find Brandon.
Don't kill me. Good sir, no. They forced me. Had I not told them, they'd have set fire to my home, my warehouse. The mage hunters know no mercy. Spare me, good man. Be not like those murderers.
Shut up. I should kill you. Thing is, you'd be no good to anyone but the gulls as a corpse. So you'll live and pay us double. Now.
Fine. Your coin.
Now, get.
Thanks, Geralt.
You should try to keep better company.
He was still better than some mages. You know, I've been thinking who might know something about Ciri. And I just got an idea. There's an Oniromancer in town, Kareem Tilly. Very capable, supposedly.
Never trusted in Dreamer's abilities myself.
Kareem's been very effective. You should at least try. She's taken a job close by. Follow the canal, away from the fish market. The house is near the first bridge. Its owner, Dejonkir, is a rich banker.
Not coming with me?
I've got some things to take care of.
Another rat-infested warehouse?
Not exactly. Nothing even remotely satisfying. Such are the times.
It was nice to see you again.
You too, Geralt. You should go now, before Kareem goes back into hiding somewhere.
What if I want to find you?
I live in the Bits, near the fish market. Stop by. It'll be nice.
All right. See you later.
Thank you.
son is dead. Stop
going in. Welcome.
What have you got? A game of... What do you... Wouldn't mind a few rounds.
need something
Thank
you, Paladin.
I'll miss a woman's touch.
Witcher!
I'm a witcher!
No strong cards, no gold king. Shan't be entering, shall we? Do we not know?
Chuh!
Yes?
Heard you play for high stakes here.
Firstly, we must have the proper effects. Let's have a look at our cards, shall we? Cards are in order, but can we afford the buy-in?
We can.
Well, let's have a name then, and we shall issue an entry ticket.
Geralt of Rivia.
Geralt of Rivia. The match will start soon, but the hoi polloi must first be driven out. We will please wait. Achoo! Tournament participants only. Everyone else out. Achoo! We are cordially invited to come back tomorrow.
Well, well. Geralt of Rivia. And I was beginning to think this tournament would be a dreadful bore. I'm afraid winning coin from peasants, thugs, and faux aristocrats is no great source of satisfaction for me.
We know each other?
Let's say we've some mutual acquaintances. I've heard many good things about you. In vivid detail.
Place like this, that's more a warning than a recommendation. What's your name?
Sasha.
Sasha what? Or maybe just skip right to telling me your real name.
Place like this, Sasha will need to suffice.
Come to the Passiflora often? Seem to know everyone.
I'm here from time to time. I cannot say all the faces are familiar, but that is Patrick Hazelnut. Never goes anywhere without those three.
Met a man once who traveled with two Zeracanian warrior women as bodyguards, but those three
have other talents, clearly. The halfling's Bernard Tully, a farmer, claims to play for pleasure. But everyone wants to win, don't they? Best beware of that one. He's not particularly fond of others, outcasts, types like you. Ironic, since Phineas himself is a half-elf. And I'm certain you've heard of Count Tybalt. After all, he is the one who organized this tournament.
Actually, I haven't heard of him.
He's reputed to be fabulously wealthy. I can't say how true it is, but he was able to afford his title and the county that came with it.
All right. See you later, Sasha.
Try to chat out the other players before the tournament begins. We must all wait for Count Tybalt anyway.
Apologies, but I must focus my thoughts before the match.
I can see that.
This will certainly serve me better than your conversation with Sasha has served you. I'd be wary of her.
Like a raw wound.
I'm new to this too. Took me ages to squirrel away the coin for the buy-in. Mushrooms are no quick route to riches.
You really a farmer?
Why not look it? Got a little farmstead just outside the city. Could sit there for days just watching things grow.
What's with the smell?
The smell? Anywho, mushrooms are all well and good, but one's got to get away at times. My lady, she was in tears, said I'd get my throat slit in Novigrad. But I says to her, I says, Hortensia, what a chance. The best players, the rarest cards. She had to let me go.
Good luck to you.
Likewise. Now, that's the sporting spirit. Not like that half-elf over there who's been shooting me murderous glares this whole time.
Style.
What? Playing tournaments often?
What are to you? Perhaps you'd wish to see my cards as well. Am I a hee-haw for you to fondle before you choose? Shall I wag my prick for you?
See your cards when we play.
You are likely to advance that far, mutant.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to our closed Gwent tournament. By closed, I mean more than the mere elite nature of the event. Anyone leaving the Passiflora before the end of play will be disqualified. That's rule number one. Rules number two, three, and four are no fighting, dirty play, or magic tricks. We play for golden figurines. The winner will take them all, along with a monetary prize equal to 9 times the buy-in. Easy enough to calculate that 9 have entered. The tournament will consist of 3 rounds. The finalist emerging from said shall play me. Players will be paired by random draw. The groupings for the first round shall be read now.
Achoo! Phineas and Tim Knott. Patrick Hazelnut and Harold Featherbuns. Gervolt of Rivia and Bernard Tull.
Ha! How about that?
Bramble Frontenstock and... Achoo! Madam Sasha.
Excellent.
A pleasant match to you all.
So pretty, but he can't keep his hands off himself. You've got brawny thighs.
Starting at last. A year down the road, I'll be plying Hortensia and my lads with tales of this night. Let's play!
Thank you.
So how did you fare in the...
Tournament's over for me. Honestly, I just came to play cards, since I lost in the first round.
I'd not expected you to give in so easily. Ah well, too bad.
As the Emperor's spies told him, Ceri had reached Novigrad. A lone attempt to find her in the North's largest city would certainly fail. But Geralt had friends he could count on. The Witcher decided to contact Triss Merigold.
Congratulations. Bit of a shame being eliminated in the first round, but so it goes. It is only a game. Having a good time, that's what matters.
So, how did you fare in the first round?
Not bad. Guessing you won too.
I've the distinct impression my opponent has drunk. Had an altogether decent hand, but...
might have had a hard time concentrating.
Care to finish this conversation in private? I've a proposition for you. Meet on the terrace upstairs.
All right.
Ooh.
Black ones for Danians. Long as they pay, I don't hit.
Alone at last.
What did you want to talk about?
A cartload of coin. That's the grand prize, you know. I can't speak for you, but I'd prefer it didn't land in the wrong hands. And luck can be so undependable. Frankly, one should simply take the coin, subtly, you know, without bothering the others.
Huh. As propositions go, this is not exactly what I was expecting. You don't seem like a...
thief? True, it's not my day job, which is why I could use some help.
Why tell me?
I'm a woman. I'm in need of that coin. And Geralt of Rivia would never abandon a woman in need, or so I heard.
Who'd you hear it from?
Fringilla Vigo. She told me of your adventures in Beauclair. Apparently you're dependable, so long as the cause is just.
Fine. Let's say I help you.
I'll split the coin with you, of course.
Split? What if I win the tournament?
I shall have another proposition for you then.
What's the plan?
I shall tell you all when the time is right. For now, just stay alert. And if you are eliminated, stay till the tournament's end. It'll be worth your while. You'll see.
All sounds pretty mysterious, but fine.
Excellent. Now that's settled, let's rejoin the others.
We wish you a pleasant match. May fortune smile. Time for round two. Your attention, please.
Madam Sasha and Gilbert of Rivia. Phineas and Harold Featherbuns.
We wish you a pleasant match. May fortune smile on you always.
Black ones for Danians. Long as they pay and don't hit.
I get no pleasure whatsoever from easy victories. So I should be very angry if you let me win.
Don't plan to. Curious about that other proposition, though.
hope your luck holds.
Ladies and gentlemen, the third round. The heat is on.
The nearest round's winner will face Count Tybalt himself in the final. Phineas and Gerard of Rivia.
Achoo!
I'll not play a mutant.
Are we to understand you forfeit this round? Fine. In that case...
No, I'm not swiving forfeit the round. I shall squash him like a louse.
A good match to you both. Please remember the tournament rules. No magic, no quarrels.
Play.
Material world, and I'm a material girl.
Mutant cheated! I'll gouge those devilish eyes out with my bare hands!
Die. Black ones for day. And don't care.
Black ones for day.
Come on, come closer.
Yeah. Ow! Yeah. Yeah.
Well played. Congratulations on both your victories. I'd wanted to summon the guards initially, but...
Yeah, it's better I took care of it.
Please, join me for the final. I must admit I did not expect this outcome. Get a rather large sum and another player, in fact.
Might have guessed there were multiple games going on.
We can go at it here, or at my place. You choose.
Let's begin.
Thank you.
superb match, I thank
you. Thief! The coin's gone.
What?
How is this possible?
No one's removed the coin from the...
Phew! We must scour the...
Before you ask...
Figured as much.
You pro...
Agreed.
We must get... I say...
A fate.
We will...
Well...
Split... Good work. I did not, in fact, suspect him, whereas he clearly caught on to me long ago.
Halflings can be unpredictable.
At any rate, we've succeeded. Now to divide the coin.
Oh yeah. So what's this proposition that's supposed to convince me to share my winnings?
No longer on the table. We retrieve the coin together. We shall divide it equally. Know what? Let's have dinner at the Kingfisher. My treat. To celebrate my last day in Novigrad.
Heading back to Nilfgaard? That why you needed the coin?
I see you miss very little.
Still got a touch of an accent.
Ah well. It seems I shall need a new trait. Anyway, I'm compromised in Novigrad, so...
Who were you before you became a spy?
I don't rightly remember anymore. But I suppose you can call me Cantarella.
That your real name?
Well, almost.
I'd love to. as it turned out, the blue-eyed prostitute was actually his sister. He couldn't believe it.
Oh, my.
He asked me to see her again at the House of the Night, and then...
Fascinating story. Shall we go upstairs? You can show...
Great idea. Slipped away without a word.
Belly. Eternal fire, how it hurts.
My head. Do you seek to keep me drunk, sir? You must get bored here.
You could not be drinking cocoa.
I believe I shall stop coming with you.
Even with the ball on, they still manage to
see that all right.
What's this? What are you doing?
Hey everyone, my name is Mike, and
giggling in the night, and furniture moving about in the attic, and last week... Well, you shan't believe it. I found human feces in the parlor.
Not interested in what's going on inside? Seeing it for yourself?
I'm a banker. Cursed homes scare me. Do you know how a haunting can affect property value? Point of fact, Corinne requested she not be disturbed.
I'd like to go inside and look around.
I don't usually let strangers rummage around my home. Twin swords, though. You're a witcher. You may enter. Call that my whim.
Truth is, we're already dependent on the Black Ones. Economically.
Stop! Go away! Don't do that. Leave it!
Wake up. It's just a dream. Wake up.
The doll. The attic.
All right. Time to check the attic.
Put it down, please. That's blood! Don't spill it! Please!
Wait, the next room's blocked. Strange stuff. A doll. Drawing shows it lying in a cradle. Maybe I should find one.
Down, please. That's blood. Don't spill it. Please.
Another masterpiece. An oven and a blackened grate. Oh, joy. A riddle. Guess I should find an oven.
Stop! Go away! Don't do that. Leave it!
Did I scare you? Scared you, didn't I? I can tell you were scared. Big brave man scared of wee little Sarah. Ain't that funny?
I wouldn't do that anymore if I were you, Sarah. You might scare someone so bad they'll hurt you.
Why would someone hurt me? Having a spot of fun's not allowed anymore.
What are you playing?
That lady fell asleep, and I've sent her some horrible dreams. I'll not her wake neither. I can do that, you know. Funny, isn't it?
Very funny. Thing is, I gotta talk to the dreamer, so I'd like you to let her wake up.
Little Sarah doesn't want her to wake. Little Sarah wants to play.
Thank you.
my back, guys.
You're lucky. I know you're a harmless godling, but others might not know, and then...
And how'd you know I'm a godling, eh? How's that, eh? Eh?
If it looks like one and acts like one, trust me, you're a godling. You give the dreamer nightmares and won't let her wake up. Why are you tormenting her?
I'm not tormenting anyone. Scary dreams are great. What I love is when this big hen chases me. Hen's got this red...
Why do you live in a haunted house?
Tell you the secret. The house ain't haunted. Not one bit. I just pretend it is. Make everyone think that. It was sitting there all empty, so I moved in. Bigwig from the bank then came and bought it. I don't like bankers, especially not to live with, so I decided to give him a scare.
Gave the banker a really big scare. See, he paid a lot for this house and won't give it up easily, which is why you need to find another home.
I don't want to! I don't! I won't!
Sarah, Novigrad's no place for a godling. But if you want to live here, that's your business. So let's make a deal.
A deal? What kind?
Leave the dreamer alone. In exchange, I'll tell the banker the house is haunted. For good, no way to lift the curse.
You tell him that? What if he doesn't believe you?
I'm a witcher. He'll believe me.
Yes, yes, yes! Do that, and I promise not to bother your friend, not even a little. You're awfully nice, you know.
I don't hear that often. Thanks.
Now go wake that sleepyhead. I won't stop her. She'll get up.
Who are you?
Triss Marigold sent me to see you.
Gods. Horrible nightmares. I was supposed to dream the history of this house. Instead, I saw furniture. Hungry furniture that wished to devour me. I know it must sound foolish. But in the dream... Well, it was all too real. And not at all amusing.
The work of a godling. She made people believe the house was haunted. Also injected your dreams with her little jokes.
And you managed to wake me. I feel fortunate.
We witchers have our ways.
I thank you very much. The dreams, they were awful. Any way I can pay you back?
There is, actually. I'm looking for a young woman who was seen in Novigrad.
I can certainly try to help. But I'll need to clear my head first. After those deranged dreams, I feel it's full of cobwebs. Find me at the Golden Sturgeon. I rent a room there.
All right. See you there.
Truth is, we're all...
I saw Miss Corrine leave, but she refused to speak to me. Is the matter resolved? Or quite the opposite?
A bit of both. A demon had captured Corrine. I managed to free her, but the house is still haunted.
Did Corrine dream of the buildings past?
Yeah. Pretty horrid, apparently. Though she refused to talk about it. Nobody should inhabit the place.
So many crowns I paid! Oh, well. It shan't put me in the poorhouse.
Truth is, we're...
A witcher?
I find it.
Truth is, we're already dependent on the Black Ones.
Damn it, lost my way again.
Looking for Roach.
No one here by that name. And
I see.
We're...
Let me get.
No.
Gonna walk.
Aye.
And you're gonna.
Aye. I'm going, indeed.
Best beware of the other side of the river.
One fire. Geralt of.
Right.
You can and.
They'll die!
We're done. Temerian.
Had came here the up when Nilf and we did. Soon up.
But
Radov.
So long.
Witcher. Just what I
Geralt of
So long.
You trouble me.
Them out there earlier than usual.
Any needs, master?
Let me live.
Dreaming here.
Never witnessed a seance like this before, let alone participated.
I will guide you. We must first achieve a kind of mental accord. I must ask some questions. You must answer them. It's important you're truthful. Answer from your heart.
Your gift. Tell me how it works.
It's hard to describe. To start with, I must gain an understanding of the bond between the person and the object I'm to dream about. I ask questions, try to flesh out feelings, emotions. Truth is essential in this. And though most who come to me acknowledge that, many refuse to speak openly of certain matters. Apart from which, they remain unaware of others, further obscuring things.
What do you see in your dreams?
I don't. It's my client who sees. My gift lies in summoning the right dreams. At times, nightmares or strong desires impose themselves on true events. It takes skill to separate seed from chaff.
Let's begin.
To start with, tell me a memory you have of this woman.
What for?
Do as I ask, please. I need the strongest, most complete memory you have of...
Ciri. The woman's name is Ciri. It was in Rivia. The second war with Nilfgaard had just ended. There was still tension in the air. For gods know what reason, race riots erupted in the town. I tried to do something, but couldn't stop a riled crowd. A boy with a pitchfork. He ran it right through my gut. Yennefer lay dying as well. Ciri had us carried onto a boat. We sailed to a place where apple trees bloom eternal. She left us there. It was the last time I saw her.
Is there anything you'd like to add? Another memory, perhaps?
Hey, bro, who's selfish?
Yes, there's something else.
All right. Tell me no more than you wish to.
I accepted a job once. Did it. Asked to choose my reward, I invoked the law of surprise. Never thought I'd actually meet the child promised to me at that time. Years later, I was in the Broccolon Forest. Happened on a girl there. Didn't know who she was. The Dryads wanted to keep her, turn her into one of their own. But the Waters of Oblivion, they failed in her case. Ciri came out of Broccolon with me. I sent her back to her grandmother then. But already, I felt bound to her.
By destiny.
By something more.
Thank you. Would you be willing to share another memory?
Yes.
No need to rush. We have time.
Ciri was orphaned during the second war with Nilfgaard. I had no idea what to do with a young girl. So I did what I would have done with a boy and took her to Kaer Morhen. Figured some physical training, sword work, development of her stamina couldn't hurt. I remember her standing on a crumbling wall. A stone came loose, she lost her footing. Caught her at the last possible instant. Strongest memory, though, is of her coming out of her room one day, wearing a dress and claiming she was indisposed. Knew then that Ciri was maturing. It was unavoidable. I was lost in the face of that.
I see. Do you wish to tell me anything more?
Yes, I think so.
In that case, I'm listening.
It was after her time training at Kaer Morhen. After the moment when Yennefer first called Ciri her daughter. We'd been separated. I knew she was in danger. I dreamt of her multiple times. I found her at Stygga Castle. She'd gone there to free Yen and gotten herself captured in the process. They wanted to hurt her. I remember fighting side by side with Ciri on stairs slippery from blood. It was the first time she ever deflected a crossbow bolt with her sword. Told her never to try it again.
You claim the woman has abilities. Tell me about them.
She's a child of the Elder Blood.
A descendant of Bloody Falkor. The rebel burned at the stake. The prophecies claim the world's destroyer will be born of the Firebrand's cursed blood.
Pure legend.
No one a legend transforms into prophecy when it gains believers. I think you're right to be reticent in talking about the woman. I see. Do you wish to say more?
Yeah. There's something else. They call Ciri the Lady of Space and Time. Once I asked Yennefer why, she travels between worlds. Turns out I don't know how to talk about it. Didn't really understand much of what Yen told me. I just know there's more to it than traveling to different places, and that Ciri carries immense power in her blood.
I see. Do you wish to say more?
Yeah. remember Ciri having trouble controlling her abilities. Yennefer tried to teach her to cast simple spells, and Ciri destroyed a shed near the temple where they were. Really upset her, but it was just an old shed. I know it took her a while to gain control, and frankly, I doubt she controls her abilities fully to this day.
I see. Do you wish to say...
No. Can we start?
Naturally. I knew you cared about her. But your tone, the emotions you so carefully conceal.
Let's continue, please.
Make yourself comfortable and try to relax. You must take my hand and talk of Ciri. Tell me where you think she might be. Who could be at her side?
Mm-hmm. If Ciri couldn't find me, I'm sure she would have looked for another friend.
Who do you mean?
Maybe Dandelion. They liked each other a lot. Of a swallow at first. After that, just nightmares.
At times, the dreams can multiply. Show the past as well as the future.
The swallow. It symbolizes Ciri. She contacted Dandelion. I didn't know he was in town.
The poet. Heard about him. Someone left him the Rosemary in Time in their will.
The Rosemary in Time? Where's that?